So I've been a math teacher at a community college for over 10 years, and I mostly teach basic math, algebra, and calculus. And I notice a lot of students, they still struggle with the math basics, in particular, the order of operations, which many of them just follow this, PEMDAS, which stands for parentheses, exponent, multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. But I think there are problems with this. So today, I want to share you two problems that I think that we have with PEMDAS, and then also share with you guys how I personally teach the order of operations. So let's begin. First problem with this is that, let's take a look at this question. 12 divided by 3 times 4. Here we have division, and then here we have multiplication. But on PEMDAS, multiplication is above division. So shall we multiply first? If we do that, 3 times 4, that's 12. And then we just bring down the 12 in the front, and then divide. 12 divided by 12, we get 1. No, this is actually not correct. No. That's one problem with PEMDAS. In fact, this and that, they are on the same level. Likewise, addition and subtraction, they are also on the same level. When you see both of them, you just do it from left to right. And I'm going to make that clear later on for you guys. But that's the first problem. The second problem is when we have PEMDAS, we have exponent, multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. Where are the other operations? Such as the square root. It's not here, right? So if I have to do the question 4 times square root of 9 like this, what do we do first? Do we multiply first? If we do that, 4 times 9, we get 36, and then do the square root, and square root of 36, we get 6. No, this is also not correct. Which is the second problem with PEMDAS. Where are the other operations? We have the square root, absolute value, and later on you also see the logarithm functions, a lot more, right? So, let me just show you guys how I will personally teach the order of operations. And I will first begin by drawing a pyramid, because this right here will show you clearly that we have different levels. And in fact, we have 4 levels. The bottom level right here, we have addition and subtraction. And that's what I meant by they are on the same level. And when you see them together in a math question right here, you just do it from left to right. And then the level above it is multiplication and also division. And when you see them together in the question here, again, you're supposed to just do it from left to right. So just real quick, let me fix this. If we have 12 divided by 3 times 4, both of these operations are on the same level, so we just proceed from left to right, which means we actually do 12 divided by 3 first, and that will give us 4, and then bring down the times 4. 4 times 4, we get 16, and this right here is the correct answer, all right? Okay, now square root, exponents, and later on in algebra you also talk about the log function. They belong to here, and I'm just going to call them special operations or other operations, special operations, operations. Anything else besides this 4, you do them first. So in fact, if you come here, we have 4, and when there's nothing between of the square root and the number 4, it means that you multiply. So 4 square root of 9, special operations such as a square root for exponent, we do that first. So work out the square root of 9, which is 3. So we have this 4, and this is 3. But as I mentioned earlier, we have to multiply. So now let's change this to a parentheses. To represent that, we are going to multiply. 4 times 3, we get 12. So that would be the answer for that. Finally, the parentheses. But when people say you do the parentheses first, they mean the inside of the parentheses. The key word, you always do things inside out. You always do things inside out. All right, let's try this one. We have 4 plus 3 times the parentheses with 5 minus 1 inside and then to the second power. Notice that we have this going on inside. And we do that first. Because whatever that's inside, it has the highest priority. It's just like you put the important mail in the priority mail and they will deliver that right away for you. Same idea. So 5 minus 1 first before anything else. For the rest, just write them down. 4 plus 3. Also put down the parentheses. 5 minus 1 is 4. And then raised to the second power. Now, what do we have next? This we have exponent. And then this is the multiplication. And then addition. Which one do we do first? The special operations, which is the exponent here. Do not multiply the 3 and 4. No. This right here goes next. So, write down the 4, and then also the plus, and also the 3. 4 squared means 4 times 4, we get 16. And let's put down a parenthesis, because this shows you that we are going to multiply. This parenthesis means we are going to multiply. I know in algebra, we are not going to see the cross for multiplication anymore. We use parentheses. So, we multiply 3 and 16. Right? Multiply before we add. So we keep the 4. 3 times 16, we get 48. Right? Lastly, we add 4 and 48, which we get 52. And that will do it for this one. All right, now let's look at this one. We have 1 plus 2 times the square root of 3 squared plus 4 squared. What do we do first? Again, it's the inside. This time we have inside of the radical that must go first. Do not do 1 plus 2. No. Inside first. So you see, inside means a lot. Inside of the square root, inside of the parentheses. So if you look at this, in fact we have 3 squared plus 4 squared. So by focusing on the inside, we will have to do the special operation first, which is the 3 squared and also the 4 squared, because they are both the squares, right? So this becomes 1 plus 2, and then maintain the square root. 3 squared is 3 times 3, which is 9. And then we add, just bring that down. 4 squared means 4 times 4, which is 16. And now this is what we have. Next, we still have to work out the inside, which is 9 plus 16, and that will give us 25. So this right here stays, and then we have the square root, and then we have 25 here. And what do we do next? Well, we worked out the special operation now, which is the square root of 25, which that will give us a 5. And then we have 1 here, plus 2 here, and remember to put down a parentheses, because when there's nothing between, it means that we are going to multiply them. So now, 1 plus 2 times 5. We multiply this first, bring down the 1, 2 times 5 is 10, and finally we see that 1 plus 10 is just 11, and then we are done.